What I want you to do is, for those of you who are taking arginine, I want you to stop taking arginine right now. I said it. I want you to slow down on the arginine, because honestly, if you don't know whether or not your gut is working properly, if we don't know whether or not that pathway is working for you with the arginine, then you can actually be doing a little bit of damage. So let me kind of show you a little bit about what I'm talking about so that it makes sense. Because arginine is something that we've talked about, and you know, because honestly, nitric oxide production comes in two different forms, right? We can make nitric oxide through the arginine pathway, and we can make it through our nitrate consumption. The problem with the L-arginine pathway for a lot of people is the fact that if that pathway isn't running right, if you are over the age of 50 and potentially you aren't making enough nitric oxide synthase to even use that L-arginine, I want you to think about it like this. Okay, everything is good in moderation, but what happens if we pile too much of anything in the body? What happens if we drink too much water, right? Say you decide, oh, I'm going to drink water all day, and you drink 5 gallons of water. Guess what? Most of you are going to end up in the emergency room if that's all you've done that day, right? Too much of anything can set things off. So I spoke with a scientist today who is behind the recipe in the Berkeley Life Professional, and she showed me scientific data that really talks about how if you aren't arginine deficient and you go ahead and load up arginine in your body, basically what you're doing is you're setting up a pathway where your body can use that arginine for all types of bad things instead of good things, right? So imagine having too much of something in your body, and now your body's like, oh shit, well, what are we supposed to do with this? I don't know what we're supposed to do with it. We'll just put it off to the side. And when you put it off to the side, it starts to create its own havoc. That arginine can actually start to create chaos and confusion. It can create pneumonia. It can cause issues, and particularly in older gentlemen. Because why? Because remember that picture that I've put up, and let me remind you of it, that picture that I've put up that shows you how over time we have a decrease in our blood vessels' ability to make nitric oxide, right? Because the nitric oxide synthase stops working as well. So what happens is, if you got too much L-arginine in the system because you're taking a bunch of it orally, what you can potentially do is not stimulate that pathway to work. Because remember, if there's the nitric oxide synthase isn't working, then all of a sudden, all that's going to shunt over and start to create a bunch of problems for you. So with that being the case, I want to make sure that you understand, if nothing else here, because some of you complaining that I'm teaching too much and have too many slides, but I want you to understand that through the years, okay, so let me put this one up. Okay, so look at this. This is how our nitric oxide goes. Oops. This is how our nitric oxide goes through the years, right? So this is representing our body's ability to make nitric oxide synthase. Nitric oxide synthase is what we're using to take that arginine that's created in our body and make nitric oxide. So if you notice, by the time we're in our 40s, we have 50% activity there. By the time you're in your 60s, you only have 15% of your activity there. This is why, for my older gentlemen, I used to use mostly beetroot supplements and things like that to boost nitric oxide production, and not necessarily arginine. Now, if you're going to use one of the supplements, L-citrulline is still okay to use, but what's happening, because L-citrulline goes into the body and our body makes L-arginine with it. But if you're giving your body straight up L-arginine and you are over the age of 40, you are potentially creating a situation for yourself of releasing toxins into your body that don't necessarily need to be there. All right, so that's this picture. Now I want to show you how there are two different pathways that we're actually using to create nitric oxide in the body, right? Remember, of course, there's the L-arginine pathway, and most of the supplements designed for the workout industry and the bodybuilders and stuff, they use a lot of L-arginine and L-citrulline, which tends to be fine for younger people who can handle all of that. But honestly, when I spoke with Dr. Beth today, her whole thing is she never gives anybody L-arginine because she just doesn't know what it's doing to the system. So let me see, where can I put this? I'm going to put this right here, right here, right here. Okay. So if you look here at our two pathways, there's the L-arginine pathway and there's the diet pathway. Now, remember what we talked about with mouthwash. I said, listen, we've got to pull back on mouthwash because mouthwash is one of the culprits in destroying the bacteria that's necessary for this second pathway to work. This one that says diet up here. Now, the cool thing about this pathway over here, this diet pathway, is that we can control that a little bit. We got plenty of control with it. We can actually load up the body with nitrates and we can see some outcomes because that can actually help you produce more nitric oxide. The pathway that we really can't control, and I'm going to zoom in on it so you can really see it, is the L-arginine pathway. We cannot control that. As time goes by, our body's ability to create nitric oxide synthase is actually destroyed. Now, there are, by eating a diet rich in nitrates, by using the smoothie recipes, this is why the smoothie recipes are helping so many people feel better, not just with their erections, but everything else, is because the nitrate level in some of those smoothies are off the charts, right? And so if we're loading up in nitrates, not only are we pushing this pathway of nitric oxide production, but we're also, get this, we're also repairing that pathway that we destroyed by taking in too much mouthwash, for taking too many acid blockers in our stomach, right? Because we block the acid here, we have trouble creating nitric oxide. If we mess up our microbiome or the bacteria in our mouth because we're using too much mouthwash, or we're swishing with hydrogen peroxide, or we've got gum disease, now what we're doing by taking in nitrates is we're actually gradually even repairing some of that microbiome and helping it get healthier. But what you don't want to do, so the bacteria that's important for this, it's on the back of your tongue. So I tell guys all the time, like, listen, if you've got to have your mouthwash, try to just keep it in the front of your mouth, right? Try to close off the back of your mouth so that it just stays right in the front and you swish it and you spit it out. Mouthwash isn't something that you should chronically be using because it can interfere with your erections. It can interfere with your blood pressure. It can interfere with the way the whole thing runs. I know I talk a lot about erections, but blood flow is blood flow. If we got heart disease, we got disease in the D. If we got disease in the D, likely we have disease in the heart. So because all of these blood vessels are supplying, they're the same, they're made out of the same stuff. They're made with endothelium.